Hey everybody, tonight I've got something a little bit different for you. If you've been following us on Facebook at RamblinAround TV, then you may have actually already read a little bit about this. A common question for me is people always like to ask me, what is my all-time favorite car? And in my case, it's actually a 1967 Shelby GT500 Mustang. I mean, I just like the fastback styling. Of course, it came with a 4-speed, and it's got the big 428 in it with dual 4-barrels. And I just think it's an awesome machine. And I grew up, my dad worked for Ford Motor Company for like 30 years, so I was kind of raised on Fords, and that's another reason, of course. But the main thing that really got me stuck on that particular model was a magazine article. And it came out when I was in grade school, and I can remember pretty vividly the entire article and what they were talking about, because it was a Cannonball Run racing Shelby GT500. It had lots of cool little features, and so that really got my mind going. You know, when you're a kid in grade school and you read about this really cool high-speed Shelby, and I just thought it was the coolest thing in the world. And one thing I think is really awesome is that with the internet, I was actually able to kind of put it out there on Facebook that I was trying to find that article. And with the help of some people, I was actually able to track that article down. All right, guys, so this is the actual magazine. As you can see, it's called Popular Hot Rodding, and it's from January 1983. And the reason I was able to actually track this down is that someone on the internet was able to remember one little detail, and that's that the article had the name Firefox in it. They remembered the car, and then it was called Firefox something. And just armed with that information, I was able to actually keep searching and searching, and eventually I came up with it. It is actually called Firefox of the Freeway, High-Tech Shelby, Built to Take on the Cannonball. And it's on page 73, so actually I flipped right to it there. And we'll go ahead and check out the article here. I will tell you one thing that kind of surprised me is when I first opened this tonight, is that the entire article is in black and white. There are no color images of the car. And the reason I found that surprising is in fact, even the other day when I put the picture on Facebook of the car, it was of a dark blue Shelby with white stripes. And that's how I've always remembered the car in this article. So when I opened this up, I couldn't believe that it was in black and white. But then I was reading through the text here, and somewhere over here it actually says the dark blue Shelby. So I guess in my mind it took the information from the text and the black and white pictures and just put it together, so I remembered it being in color. But in this first image here, you can actually see there's quite a bit going on in this car. It's got a custom aluminum console with some extra switches, a bunch of extra gauges, some headphones hanging down here, a CB, and I believe this is a radar jammer up in there. So a lot of cool stuff going on in this car. And that's really what kind of captured my imagination when I was a kid. There's kind of a James Bond element to this car, and I'll show you some of that right here. It is actually powered by a 428 Cobra Jet with dual 4-barrels, and it's balanced and blueprinted, and it just says it produces in excess of 400 horsepower. And it can get it up to 150 miles an hour, it says, which is definitely moving along at that time. You know, this is prior to everybody having 1,000 horsepower cars and that kind of stuff. But one of the coolest things about the car, it really grabbed my attention when I was a kid, is inside of this aluminum console that he built, he had this switch panel, this really James Bond style stuff. And, a lot of it, as an adult looking at it, obviously it's going to be like a fuel pump and electric fans and lights and that sort of thing. So maybe it's not that cool, but as a kid, you think this is just awesome stuff, And a couple things are pretty cool. At the time, I didn't hear as much about electric cutouts in your exhaust and that kind of thing. And I just thought it was really cool that you could kind of drive quietly through town, flip a switch and open your headers and then just, crank 150 miles an hour, and I thought that was just the coolest stuff, and I guess I kind of still think it's cool. Then it had these additional switches in front of the console that actually controlled some aircraft landing lights that were below the front bumper, and then the four lights on the front of the Shelby are all quartz headlamps, and those were controlled by one of these switches as well. So it definitely had plenty of lighting for driving high speed at night, which I also thought was pretty cool. And then one picture that I remember pretty vividly from the time is this extra gas tank. They actually added 47 gallons of additional fuel on top of the original 15-gallon tank, so it holds a total of 62 gallons. And it says right here that it could cruise at 17 miles per gallon at 80 miles per hour, and which would give it a pretty darn good range. That sounds a little optimistic to me for a 428 with dual four barrels, but you know, maybe that's possible, I suppose. But then they have various specs on the car and that sort of thing. Another thing that it has that's pretty cool, it actually had a couple switches to control the taillights of the car. He could flip a switch and turn off all the rear lights. So if you wanted to duck down a road to, you know, get away from the cops, you could flip them off and just go dark. But the other thing that I thought was pretty ingenious is it actually had a switch that would reconfigure the lights. So let's say you have three lights across there on each side and it's got the outside lights lit up. It would flip a switch and configure them to a closer proximity, and that way it would actually make the car look different at night. So I thought that was pretty cool stuff at the time. And obviously for Cannonball Run Racing, they made quite a few changes to the car. It had a 10-quart oil pan. They took the 4-speed out, put a Doug Nash 5-speed, it says, 247 rear-end gears, because they just want that top-end cruising, obviously. Four-wheel disc brakes. But the coolest stuff is all the electronic equipment. And if you can see that listed right down here, two radar detectors, two CB radios, a programmable police scanner, a mobile telephone, which at that time, you know, that was really something, and a radar communicator, which is actually a radar jammer, meaning that, at least at the time, when they would hit you with the radar, it could be programmed to send out a signal, basically. And so if you're going 80, it would just send out a signal that said 55 and just kind of jam up the radar there. Then also, like I said, the four quartz headlamps, aircraft landing lights, all the cutout switches for the rear lights. Let's see, electrically heated windshield wipers, headlight washers, and supposedly radar wave absorption material along the underside of the hood. That's pretty crazy stuff, and I gotta assume all that's the real deal, because you can look at the car and it looks like it appears to have all that equipment on it. One thing I will say, the article itself was a piece of fiction. Basically, it's just a really cool story about this guy, you know, basically, you know, pulling J-turns and 180s and, you know, running from the cops and flipping open the headers and going 150 miles an hour and all kinds of cool stuff. So, yeah, they did make up, you know, a lot of the story, obviously, just to kind of make for an interesting article. But everything that I can tell was true about the car, it seems. And like I said here, the 5-speed with 247 rear axle, it can cruise at 90 miles an hour at 3,000 RPM, and it could cruise at 130 with the same sort of confidence that you cruise at 60 in the regular car. You know, when you're a kid in grade school, this is just awesome stuff. But at the end of the article here, they actually have a little editor's note, and it says, you know, this story, of course, was pure fiction, but the Shelby does exist exactly as told, and it has run the U.S. Express New York to San Diego road race, as well as many unofficial encounters across the country. So, you know, I think that's pretty cool stuff.
But anyway, guys, I just thought you might find that interesting. You know, I just think it's kind of cool that, like, you know, unlike a lot of things, you know, like when you're a kid, you watch a television program or a movie and you remember how awesome it was. But then as an adult, you go back and check it out and you're like, wow, this is really stupid. And but I didn't feel that way about this magazine article. It actually is pretty much as I remembered it, other than I, for some reason, remembered the article in color. But I mean, all the features of the car are pretty much exactly what I thought they were, and actually makes me want one of these GT500s even more than ever. And I just think it's cool to actually be able to find that, track that magazine down, get it here, and then not be disappointed at all. I really, I just think it's so cool. I mean, like, I almost want to, like, take this and frame it or something. I really don't know. But anyway, I just thought you guys might find it interesting. I appreciate you watching and commenting and everything, and I'll see you later. Bye.